Alrighty, it's 4:08 p.m. and this is Monday, September the 3rd, 2018. And it's looking very much like bullshit in the world of baseball right now. The Winnipeg Goldeyes just completed their worst season in existence as to victories, as to the season itself. Goldeyes today played their last game in St. Paul at CHS Field. In that game, they were up 5-0 and 6-1 and lost 11-10. Essentially, what that means is the Goldeyes finish the season with a shitty record of 41-59, basically 41% winning percentage. Pardon me. Finishing fourth in the North Division, 18 games back of first. The only other team that was shittier than them were the Sioux Falls Canaries at 40-60 and 19 games back. So by wins-loss record, this is the worst the Goldeyes have ever had. 41 wins, their very first season in 94, the year they won the championship, but that was of the Northern League. That was a much different time in baseball. That year, I think they had a total of 43 victories. But then again, there were, I think it was only an 80-game schedule, and there was two halves to the season. So, but regardless, if you want to talk win-loss, this is the worst season. It was a horrible year all around in general. Pitching was an atrocity. Fielding was crap. They couldn't do jack shit. They couldn't keep the lead. They couldn't do anything this year. It was horrible. And there was like literally only maybe half a dozen games that were exciting, including the game that I went to on my birthday where they were down 4-0 and won 5-4 in the bottom of the ninth. That was one of the handful that were like good. But they really blew it this year. There's going to be no three-peat championship. And the funniest thing is, 2015 was the last time they missed it. That was another bad year for pitching. And then, of course, 16-17, they won the championship. And now they're on the outside looking in big time. And I'll tell you one thing. Goldeye management, there needs to be a change once and for all. Rick Forney needs to go, boy. He needs to get the hell out of here. Like, fucking high-step it quick. They need to get rid of everybody in management, including Collier, general manager. Goodbye, motherfucker. This organization needs new blood. No. Here's the thing that's going to be. People are going to say, well, they just won back-to-back championships. They have a bad year. But the problem with that is these things tend to continue. Because the bad habits that have not been learned, they'll continue next year. Rick Forney's been on for 13 years. I think it's time to cut ties, say adios amigos, and let's go a whole different way. A whole new regime here. I'm talking field manager, first base coach, like Tom Vaith, gone. Pitching coach is gone. Let's try something new. Let's go a whole new direction because this is not working. What a horrible season. Like I said, Goldeyes just completed the worst season in franchise history. Of course, you had the Northern League, which was from, what, 94 to... I forget what year they were done to the Northern League. 2010? I think starting 11... They were in the American Association, and they've had pretty good numbers in the American Association. But like I said, just terrible this year. Now, I'm looking right now, following the games as of right now. And with that St. Paul victory, of course, that puts St. Paul first place. Now, St. Paul will play Gary because there is no wild card this year. St. Paul plays Gary, and the Sioux City Explorers, who are just amazing this year, they'll play the Kansas City T-Bones because Wichita was eliminated the other night. So in the end, what I want here, I want to see the Explorers win it to win the championship. But St. Paul is a half game in first right now. If Gary loses, which they're up 3-2 in the bottom of the eighth inning, or is actually going to the top of the ninth, if Gary wins, then they're tied. That means I think they play a one-game playoff, and the winner of that, then they'll open up at home to that winner of that. If Gary loses, which, like I said, up 3-2 going top nine, that means if they lose, then game one will be in St. Paul. Now, Sioux City, they play game one regardless. I mean, they're sitting right now 71-28. I mean, that's an amazing season. The Goldeyes can learn a thing or two. But, yeah, and then you're going to look at other teams right now. I mean, for those of you, the Texas Air Pigs, man, that is a fucking brutal franchise. Right now, 25-74, which is good enough for 25%. That's like winning one out of every four games. That's horrible. And the fact that it's a very unique situation there, because the Texas Air Hogs have, I mean, 99% of their fucking franchise are from the Chinese players, from however that works. They were getting these players that were coming in, and so really they don't play North American style kind of idea, so they're like really shitty. And 25 victories. I mean, that's a fucking atrocity. I got to take a look to see what the record is for the least amount of wins in a season. I don't know if that's close to a record, and I'll check it out and do another video later. But yeah, just in general, the league this year, of course, no wild card this year. It was the first place team and the second place team playing each other, which, you know, overall doesn't really make a difference, and it just makes you fight all that much harder to keep pace. So there you go. We'll come back in a little while and we'll see what happens with that game. Actually, we're just going to sit on it here. I'm going to try to sit on it for as long as I can, because I got to get in here. Okay. We're just going to sit on it here. The top of the ninth inning, Gary 3-2 over the Kansas City Stakes, and there's one out. There's two out. So if Gary wins, which it looks like they very well may, that means they'll be tied with St. Paul at the end of basically the end of the season. And that means there'll be a one-game playoff. Where they'll play that, I don't know. Literally, I don't know if they just kind of like literally flip a coin and say, somebody choose, that's where you play. I don't know. But I'd like to, if that is, either way, they're going to play each other. I'd rather see Gary beat St. Paul. I want to see Sioux City beat Kansas. And then in the end, see the, pardon me, the Sioux City Explorers win the championship. I think St. Paul last won it in, 2004? 5? Something like that. I can't remember. It's been a while. Gary won it not too long ago. Kansas City, I don't think they've ever won it. I can't remember. Again, just like the Goldeyes, look at the Texas Air Pigs. They won it in, 2011? I remember that year they were an awesome baseball club. But, of course, that was a whole different thing because they were known as the Grand Prairie Air Hogs. And it was a whole different scenario. This year with a very unique situation there, I don't understand it. Then you have the Cleveland Railroaders that absolutely suck ass. Lincoln suck ass this year. Wichita, I'm glad, totally missed the playoffs. It was beautiful. And, of course, you got the Chicago Dogs in the north with the Goldeyes that actually finished above them. Just blown away. Fargo was very much on track with Gary and St. Paul at one time. And then they went to hell. In fact, the Goldeyes, actually, the only thing they did useful all season was end Fargo's chance at a playoff position. So they did something good. So just waiting here to see what happens. Top nine, two out. No, there's a man on. He just walked them. 3-2 Gary over the stakes. Both of these clubs, like I said, are in the playoffs. It's just a matter now. The only thing left is if Gary wins, there's a playoff between them and St. Paul. Not playoffs, but they'll have to play one game. I believe they'll play a one-gamer, and that decides where they play to open it up because it's a best of five. Three, you go to the championship, and I believe the playoffs begin Wednesday or Thursday. But I want to see Sioux City win this whole thing. Fucking end the fucking game already, man! I hate these kind of fucking things. If I'm wrong on this, I will do another video. I'm going to do one regardless once the... depends on how this goes. But anyway, a very disappointing season for the Goldeyes. Like I said, worst season as to record winning percentage. Just like 41 out of 100 victories. That is just fucking awful. The pitching is just disgusting. How many guys this year went to the Mexican League? I mean, what the fuck, man? But I really think it is time for a dismantle. Like I said, I don't know what's going to happen to Butters, Josh Mazzola, if he's going to go or stay. Abercrombie, I don't know. I'm not sure what the fuck's up with that shit, but... One thing is for sure, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Rick Forney to go, not just because of the record, but because how he operates the bullpen, how he does all that shit. It's his method of operandi that is absolutely fucking just brain dead, and it doesn't work, man. It's time to go. 13 years, bye. Forget Semenuk, forget that. I don't know who else they'd bring in, but I think it's time to get somebody in here who has a whole different mentality. Somebody who's not afraid to put their foot down, but fairly. Someone who's willing to face the officials and actually say, fuck you, you know, that type of thing. It's sick, it's stupid. Just waiting on this. Please don't fucking walk this guy and then I gotta wait around. Just end it right here. Gary South Shore Railcats. They can put it away right here. Top nine, 2-2, with two out, a man on. 3-2. Let's go, Cats! Oh, he fucking walks them, you stupid motherfucker. I see you, you motherfucker, you. Son of a bitch. Sorry, I'm just doing something here. Okay, sorry. All right. Doesn't it fucking figure, though? Doesn't it figure? All right. No balls, one strike. Let's go, Railcats. Come on. Just sit there, fucking sit them down, end the game. Both teams are in the playoffs. Just a matter of a seeding position for Gary. You want to open up at home, obviously. I want Gary to beat St. Paul, like I said. Sioux City to beat the Stakes. That's Kansas City T-Bones. That's 0-2! Come on, fucker. Then there's other games here that don't mean a damn thing. The game between the Salt Dogs and Salt Dogs and Chicago Dogs... That was raining at one point, and they just canceled it because it doesn't matter who wins or loses. It didn't make a bit of difference. So that's been canceled, which means it's just going to go in the books as a non-game played. Fuck. Then Wichita beat the one. They beat Sioux City. That must have just ended. Insult to injury. Oh, for fuck's sake, 1-2. Would you just throw a strike, end the game. This always happens at the wrong fucking time. What a time. Would Rick Forney go to Gary to show him how to do it? Holy fuck. Sorry, I'm just hitting our little refresh here off and on. 2-2. Way to go. Awesome. I'm running like a 15-minute video here. I did not intend on this happening. If he walks him and loads the bases, I just quit. Two and two. Two out. Two men on. Come on, Gary. End the game. Just put it down right here. End it and go to the one-game playoff with St. Paul. I'm guessing that's how that's going to work because it makes sense. Because then they'd be tied and I don't know if there's a rule change in the tiebreaker. I don't think there is. Except the wild card's the only difference for playoffs. One thing I do know about the American Association website, they need to update this website properly. There's a lot of things like that are no longer the way it is and they still have it. Like, I don't mean graphics, I just mean information. Yeah, Gary wins! Gary beats the stakes 3-2. That means it's now Gary St. Paul tied in the standings. Season's over for them. And I'm guessing, unless there's a rule change I don't know about, there'll be a one-game playoff between Gary and St. Paul. Winner gets home field advantage. Where they would play that, I don't know. Let's see. That's that. The only other game, that's it. The only other game is Cleburne, Texas. And that's 15-2 for the Railroaders, but and that's the end of that one too. So the Air Pigs, Cleburne beats Texas 15-4. That means that the Texas Air Hogs finished the season. Oh my God, 25-75. Holy fuck, gotta check that. Anyway, that's that. American Association 2018 season is now over. Playoffs will begin. Well, there's still actually one more to go. That would be the Gary game if they one game playoff. That is that. That looks like it's all over. We'll come back in a bit and I'll do the standings business once and for all. And yeah, Goldeyes are done. Go Sioux City to win the championship. Yeah, very disappointing season.